possibility of life after death is explored in Phoenix, Arizona by the Cryonics Society. They believe that cryobiology, the freezing of biological matter, is the answer. They propose freezing bodies in cold storage capsules.
Cryopreservation technology changed tremendously over the years. My name is Emil. I'm a founder and CEO at Tomorrow Bio. And today I will give you an overview of how it changed from the past to right now. In the very beginning, when we talked about human preservation, it wasn't actually any type of specific preservation technology. It was basically just what is sometimes now called freezing people when we talk to newsletters or newspapers. That was in fact the case. Like, you were just cooling down people to, in the end, cryogenic temperatures, but without any specific technology that stopped ice crystals from forming once the body reached temperatures lower than 0 degrees Celsius. Now, this would be considered a straight freeze, which of course, as everybody knows who is in the field, is usually associated with very, very low quality. Low quality in that regard means that there's a tremendous amount of ice crystal formation, which creates tremendous damage to the tissue. I'm not necessarily saying this might never be fixable, but it's definitely on the lower end of the quality spectrum of preservations that are being done today. Then at some point, after this phase in the beginning, when everything was just frozen, you started to implement the first generation of cryoprotective agent. Basically solutions that when you cool down, they allow tissue and the whole body to be cooled below 0 degrees Celsius without ice crystals forming. Now, of course, perfusion with cryoprotective agent is standard procedure. And these are not the cryoprotective agents of old. These are newer generations that are optimized to allow A, less ice crystal formation, and B, as much as possible, reduce toxicity. Toxicity in that regard would be measured by viability assays. So you put the cryoprotective agent on cells or organs, and then when you take them out, you see how much of the organs, how much of the cells still survive. These metabolic assays are being used to see if basically the metabolic activity of the cell still works, showing viability. These two factors are not perfect. There's still ice crystal formation under certain temperatures. There's still ice crystal formation if not enough highest concentrations are being reached, and there's still toxicity. So these cryoprotective agents are continuously being developed and improved. Again, mostly to reduce toxicity and reduce the amount of ice crystals that are forming. I said it in another video, one of the advances, one of the technology improvement directions that we're working on is adding blood-brain barrier modifiers to these cryoprotective agents. This has been a topic that has been discussed for quite a while, where the cryoprotective agent doesn't easily go outside the vessels in the brain because there's a blood-brain barrier, basically a barrier that is there to not be crossed, and you add modifiers to let the cryoprotective agent go into the tissue where it's supposed to stop ice crystal formation. Right now, the most prominently used cryoprotective agent are either M22 or VM1, or an alternative of 2VM1 or an optimization to VM1. M22 is being used mainly by Alcor, VM1 mainly used by CI, by Cryonics Institute, and an optimized version of VM1 is used, for example, by us, by Tomorrow Bio. All of these cryoprotective agents are trying to keep the least possible ice crystals after cooling to cryogenic temperatures and have the highest possible viability. They differ in price, they differ in small, factors, but compared to the days of old when we didn't have any cryoprotective agent and just basically, everything was straight frozen, and then the first generation of cryoprotective agent, these cryoprotective agents that are being used today are significantly better. Even though when I say significantly better, this doesn't mean that there wouldn't be ample room for significant improvements over the next, years and decades, one of which, of course, that we're working on. Well, this is a short overview of how method of preservation changed over the years from straight freezes to cryoprotective agent, that are getting better and better. And as we discussed in other videos, apart from cryopreservation, there's also the combination of cryopreservation and chemical fixation. For example, aldehyde stabilized cryopreservation that under certain circumstances can give advantages in preservation quality. If you want to learn more about what we do, feel free to reach out at any point, as I always say, or leave a comment below, or last but not least, always feel free to go to our webpage, tomorrow.bio, reach out to us and have a conversation with us one-on-one.